Vatican Viewpoint, the Church in the World, seen from Rome. A podcast produced by Vatican Radio. I'm your host, Devin Watkins.
He is watching.
Who is that?
To all of you, I bring a message of communion and closeness from His Holiness Pope Francis, who has been journeying with us these past days, even from Rome.
Ah, well, they do say that 50% of every joke reflects the truth.
Why journey together? Isn't it more pleasant to go my own way?
Okay, getting serious now. That was Cardinal Luis Antonio Tagle. He was the Pope's special envoy to a meeting in Thailand.
There is no other path for FABC, the Federation of Asian Bishops Conferences, but to journey together. Journeying together must be intended. We must choose to journey together. Even 4 months of discussing journeying together will not amount to anything unless we intend. We choose it as the path. We journey together.
As he said, the Philippine-born cardinal was speaking to members of the FABC as the group marks its 50th anniversary with its first ever general conference. Yep, it only took 50 years.
God wants us to journey with those who might differ from us.
Cardinal Tagle wrapped up the FABC 50 conference with Mass in Bangkok. The event spanned nearly 3 weeks and saw bishops from across Asia make the journey to the Thai capital, along with religious men and women and lay people working in the church.
God wants us to journey with those who are hiding in shame, or being hidden by others. God wants us to journey with the isolated, the friendless, the despised, the shamed, those in dark alleys and slums, those crossing mountains, rivers, seas in the dark of night. God wants us to journey also with those who are in high positions in politics, in business, in the military. God wants us to journey with the poor, despised, and marginalized, the refugees, migrants, displaced, and indigenous peoples, the wounded and exploited earth, the youth, the women, the families. We will walk together as you face rejection, as we face extremism, as we face threats to life, as we face violence, conflicts, and the ambivalence of the digital revolution.
As you might have guessed, the theme of the FABC conference was Journeying Together as Peoples of Asia, with a subtitle, And They Went a Different Way.
It will be a journey of mercy, compassion, not of destruction. A journey of patience and not condemnation. A journey that ends in the beautiful land of justice and charity.
And which way is that, Cardinal Tagle?
Jesus is the different way. Different from those who disrupt unity in order to maintain division. Different from those who want to keep others unseen and non-existent. Jesus is the way and shows a different and renewed way all the time.
You're listening to Vatican Viewpoint. This week, we're exploring the Federation of Asian Bishops Conference's General Conference, which took place in Bangkok on October 12th to 30th, 2022.
I think it's going to make a difference. The hope is this conference should make a difference to our pastoral work.
Cardinal Oswald Gracious speaking. He's the Archbishop of Bombay in India.
Being here in a continent where we are not the majority, they've got lots of people to serve, I saw the cry again, the call to really go out and serve everybody. try dialogue, try reconciliation, peace-building efforts, be bridges between communities, conflicting people.
Cardinal Gracious thinks the FABC 50 conference will help set the church in Asia on a path toward renewal.
This conference was specifically called for to see what should be the pastoral priorities, rethink, examine the way we went so far, the pastoral priorities, our work, missions in different fields, and to see what we should do differently, what we should do better, what should we do with renewed enthusiasm.
Ahead of the FABC General Conference, Pope Francis asked the bishops to carefully consider the question, what is the Holy Spirit saying to the churches in Asia?
During these 2.5 weeks, we really feel that the Holy Spirit is really leading us and guiding us. We are very much strengthened of this grace of the Holy Spirit, and especially the fraternity that is found here.
Cardinal Charles Muang Bo there. He is the president of the FABC and Archbishop of Yangon in Myanmar.
Asia has a lot of challenges of militarization and also nuclearization and everything. Asia is producing the biggest amount of poor people here. It's also very challenging, especially for building peace. So I foresee that and vision that the Holy Spirit is leading Asia to building peace, dialogue or reconciliation. It's a new word for the evangelization, new evangelization mostly needed.
Pope St. Paul VI set the ball rolling for the foundation of the FABC when he visited Manila in 1970. Now, 50 years later, the FABC General Conference has been about seeking to trace out the new direction for the church in Asia, a path which they hope will lead to peace.
We are not forgetting the past. The founding fathers of this FABC have already marked the road, giving us a road map of a triple dialogue, or maybe triple harmony. Harmony with the poor, harmony with religions, and harmony with the culture. With that harmony, plus we now need to add harmony with the ecology, harmony with nature. With those four dialogues, I think the church in Asia will have to build peace, peace in that part of the Asia.
Thank you for joining us here on Vatican Viewpoint. We'll be back again next week.